connections. So today I'm going to be showing you how I got this deep and sultry Christmas look. This is really a look for pretty much any time because it's one of my favorite go-tos, featuring one of my favorite red lips as part of my Who Says Black Girls Can't Wear Red series. So if you want to see how I get this look, don't forget to like and subscribe, and just keep on watching. I really just want to listen to music and do this makeup look, so maybe I'll just end up doing that. So yeah, I primed my LA Girl primer. Today I'm not going to use foundation because I ran out of foundation, because sometimes you run out of foundation and you're broke and you can't buy more foundation until Friday when you get paid. So I'm going to do my concealer method, which is pretty much what I prefer anyway, especially for like every day, but this isn't really an everyday look for most people. It is for me though, because it's every day and I'm going to be wearing it. But yeah, I'm going to do my concealer method, which is basically the same as my regular method, just with concealer only. So yeah, and this is pretty long lasting because literally I did this method and I went out for like 6 hours and I came back and my makeup was still there, and I was like, oh snap, you know, for some basic base, you know, it stayed on pretty well. So I'm going to start off with my LA Girl Pro Concealer, as usual, in the color Chestnut. I went to NYX the other day, and I got this really pretty eyeshadow. I'm going to swatch it for you guys. It's a really pretty one. It's kind of like holographic, and I'm going to be using it on mirrors. I don't know if you can see your app. But it's just like this iridescent bluish, kind of, I don't even know, bluish, pinkish, brownish type of color. It's really pretty. Yeah, I want to do a look with it, so if you're watching this and you want me to do a New Year's get ready with me, because I really want to do that. I won't do it on New Year's though, but I'll basically just go through the same steps that I'm going to be doing on New Year's. So if you want me to do a New Year's get ready with me video, then you should leave a comment down below or like this video and just let me know if you want to see that, because I want to do it. So I'm going to highlight your face with Espresso. I'm going to put a lot of this on though, because, well, not a lot, but a decent amount. I basically like put it on like how I would usually, and then I just like put it all over, spread it all over with my beauty blender. You'll see what I mean. I'm gonna highlight a little bit more in my under eyes and T-zone and chin and upper lip with my LA Girl in Tawny. The other day, actually yesterday, some lady complimented me on my eyebrows, and she was like, "Your eyebrows are so nice. How long does it take you to do them? 2 hours?" I was like, "2 hours? Can you imagine? It took me 2 hours just to do my eyebrows. I wouldn't even bother with makeup anymore." Now that I highlighted, I'm gonna contour my face now. I'm gonna use my LA Girl Pro Coverage Foundation. Like usual, LA Girl should like sponsor me, like, but like, I use a lot of their products. Like, literally, my entire base was LA Girl. Okay, so I'm gonna actually do my eyebrows now, and I'll be right back. So from here, I'm just gonna set both my highlight and my concealer. I'm gonna set my highlight with my Bed Knight powder, and I'm gonna set the concealer with this Ruby Kisses eyeshadow in the color Beau Ruben. And I'm also gonna use the Bed Knight powder to set my eyelids. I know my eyebrows were looking type weak when I came back from doing them, but this is the reason why. I always go over my eyebrows at the end, just in case, you know, any mess occurs, and then put on my final layer. If you don't know how I do my eyebrows, you should go totally watch my eyebrow video, because it's up right now. Oh, I forgot to highlight my contour. So I'm just gonna dust it off now. I'm just right now using the powder brush to kind of like buff all the powder into my skin. Just gonna pat right here just to make sure it gets into my pores. I have pretty deep pores out of nowhere. Like, I never used to, but then all of a sudden I did. But they're not always there, so I don't really know. I'm gonna go start with my eyes now. Guess what color I'm going to use as a transition shade. If you're one of the few people that watch me every week, you know what shade I'm gonna use. So I'm going to use this Morphe color Flame, and I just really like using orange shades as like transition colors, so that's what I'm going to do. So yeah, I'm just going to blend that into a crease. I'm going to use my BH88 matte palette. And I'm gonna use these two shades right here, and I'm gonna blend that as well into my crease. Now I'm gonna take a smaller blending brush, and I'm gonna use this shade in my Morphe 35W palette. I'm gonna put that lower into my crease and blend it up. I think I'm going to also add a little bit of this dark purple shade right here. I'm just going to focus that on the outer V and outer crease. Just to darken it and give it some depth. And now I'm going to go into my Shani palette, and I'm going to take up this really, really, really pretty red shade right here. And I'm just going to apply that all over my eyelid. Because when I do this, I always use a wet brush. I don't know. I hope it doesn't look as pink on camera as it does for me, looking at it from my computer, because it's actually really red. Okay, and now I'm going to take the dark red shade from the Morphe palette again, and I'm going to take it up onto that red, to the crease. Now on top of that red, I'm going to go into my Anastasia palette. I'm going to use this pretty gold shade called Fifth Ave. And with a small shading brush, I'm just going to pack that onto the center. I changed my brush because I actually preferred using a bigger shading brush than a smaller one. I'm going to blend those colors into the crease. Now I'm going to use this Tarte Sex Kitten pencil liner, and I'm going to line my upper waterline. Now using the liquid liner, I'm going to line my lash line very thinly. And I'm not going to do a wing. And I'm going to use my Tarte's mascara on my lashes. And for my brow bone, I'm going to use my Anastasia color Hollywood right here. So now I'm going to put on some lashes, touch up my brows finally, and I'll be right back for the last steps of this video. Be right back. Going back in with the dark red Morphe shade, I'm going to put that on my outer lower lid. So now that I've done that, I'm going to put some blush on my cheeks. I'm going to use this shade from my BH Cosmetics mixed with a little bit of this shade. So I'm going to add my highlight. Today I'm going to be using a new highlight palette I'm gonna use this one right here, this color right here, and I'm gonna put that on my cheeks. You know what I mean. Bless me. So now it's time for my favorite part, which is the lips. So I'm going to use this NYX Suede Matte Lip Liner in the color Club Hopper, and I'm going to be using my LAX in ColourPop. My ColourPop LAX Matte Liquid Lip.